Hello students, today we are going to solve some problems which are depend on the concept volume of sphere. Okay, see here, what is the problem? A vessel is in the form of an inverted cone, its height is 8 cm and the radius of its top, which is open, is 5 cm. It is filled with water up to the rim. When lead shots, each of which is a sphere of radius 0.5 cm are dropped into the vessel, are one fourth of the water flows out, find the number of lead shots dropped in the vessel. Okay, this is the given question. Now we will see, according to this question, we will try to prepare your figure. What is given? See, first statement, a vessel is in the form of an inverted cone. Okay, it is in the form of inverted cone. So if you will try to prepare your figure, then you will get like this somewhere. Okay, so a vessel is in the form of an inverted cone. Its height is 8 cm. Its height is given 8 cm. Height is equals to vertical height, 8 cm. Okay, and the radius of its top, which is open, is 5 cm. This top is open. Radius is given 5 cm. Okay, and it is filled with water. It is filled with water. It is come up to the rim. Okay, it is filled with water. It contains water. So now what happens after this? When lead shots, each of which is a sphere of radius 0.5 cm, are dropped into the vessel. Okay, what is given? A sphere of radius 0.5 cm. A sphere of radius 0.5 cm. So suppose this is that sphere whose radius is 0.5 cm. Are dropped into the vessel. Like that, some spheres are there. That number of spheres we are going to find out. Understood? So a sphere of radius 0.5 cm are dropped into the vessel. Then 1/4 of the water flows out from this 1/4 water flows out. 1/4 water flows out. So what they are asking? 1/4 of the water flows out, find the number of lead shots dropped into the vessel. Okay, so how many lead shots are dropped into the vessel? That is the question that we are going to find out. Okay, so first we need to decide the flow of answer. Okay, actually what we are going to do, that we need to think before that, and then we can apply that for solution. Okay, so what we need to find out here? See, it contains water. Okay, this vessel contains water. So we need to find out volume of this vessel. Okay, so this is conical. So we can find out volume of this very easily with the help of formula 1/3 pi r² h. Okay, so here radius is given 5 cm, height is given 8 cm. So easily we will get volume of the vessel. Okay, once we will get volume of the vessel, what we need to do? We need to find out volume of a sphere. Okay, volume of sphere is equal to 4/3 pi r³. So that also you will get, because radius is given here 0.5 cm. Radius is given 0.5 cm. Understood? Now, one more thing we need, that is given, it is filled with water up to the rim. When lead shots, each of which is sphere of radius 0.5 cm are dropped into the vessel, 1/4 of the water flows out. 1/4 of the water flows out. Okay, so definitely whatever water is going to come, 1/4 of the water flows out. Okay, whatever water is going to flow outside, that volume and the volume of sphere will be equal. Understood? So what we need to do here, first we will find out volume of vessel. Okay, then what we will do, we are going to find out 1/4 of that volume, because that volume, that amount of water is coming out. Okay, so we will find out 1/4 of that, and then we will find out volume of a sphere, and then we will divide 1/4 volume divided by volume of a sphere. Okay, that time we will get number of spheres, number of lead shots dropped into the vessel. Okay, so first I am going to start here. See here, first I am going to find out volume of this conical vessel. Okay, so radius is given radius is equals to 5 centimeter. Then height is given 8 centimeter. Okay, then volume of vessel is equals to 1 by 3 pi r square h. So that is equals to 1 by 3 into pi is 22 by 7. Radius is given 5 centimeter, so 5 multiply by 5, and height is 8 centimeter, so 8 will come here. Okay, so here now we need to multiply, that is 22 into 5 5s are 25 25 8s are 200 200 divided by 21. Okay, so it will be 22 2s are 44 4400 divided by 21 centimeter cube. So that is the volume of that conical vessel. Okay, this is the volume of conical vessel. Now what we will do, 1/4 of the water flows out. 1/4 of the water flows out. When it flows out, when some spears, lead shots are dropped into the vessel. So definitely 1/4 of this volume, 1/4 of the volume of conical vessel is equals to the volume of spears or lead shots also we can say. Okay, so now we are going to find out 1/4 of the volume of conical vessel. Okay, so is equals to 1/4 of the volume of conical vessel is equals to volume of lead shots. Okay, definitely this will be the same. So I am going to find out now 1/4 of the volume. So 1/4 of the volume of conical vessel is equals to 1/4 into 4400 upon 21. Okay, so here you will get 1100 upon 21 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of 1/4 means flows out water. Understood. So this volume we will compare. This volume is our required answer. Okay. Now what we are going to find out? We are going to find out volume of a lead shot. So volume of lead shot, that is spherical in shape, lead shot is equals to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, what is radius given? Radius is given 0.5 centimeter. Okay, radius is given 0.5, so we can write 0.5, we can write 5 by 10 also. Okay, so pi, value of pi, 22 by 7, that we will put here, that is equals to 4 by 3 into 22 by 7 multiply by radius is 5 by 10 into 5 by 10 into 5 by 10. Okay, so it will be, we can cancel this, 5 2s are 10 5 2s are 10 5 2s are 10. So here 2 11s are 2 2s are 4, and this 2 will be cancelled. So what is going to remain here? 11 upon 7 3s are 21. Okay, centimeter cube. So this is the volume of lead shot. So we are going to find out here number of lead shots. To find out that, what we need to do here, we will divide this volume by the volume of a lead shot. Okay, so number of lead shots is equals to volume of 1/4 water, 1100 upon 21 divided by volume of a lead shot. Okay, is equal to 11 by 21. Okay, so here 1100 divided by 21 multiply by 21 upon 11, so 21 will be cancelled, so here remain 100. 11 ones are 11 100. Lead shots are dropped into the vessel, then 1/4 of the total water will come outside. Understood? What did everybody, once again see what we have done. Radius, this was conical vessel. So we have to find out volume of that because it contains water. When some lead shots are dropped into that, okay, that time 1/4 of the total water, okay, comes out, means close out. Okay, so first we have to find out volume of conical vessel, that we got this 4400 upon 21. Then 1/4 we need to find out, because 1/4 water is coming out, flows out, and that volume is equals to the volume of a volume of spears, volume of lead shots. Okay, so that we have taken here, 1/4 of this will be, we have to divide 1/4 of this, we will get 1121. Volume of lead shots is equal to, it is spherical, so 4/3 pi r³. So when you will solve, that time you will get 11/21. This is volume of a lead shot. So we need to divide here, number of lead shots is equals to 1/4 of the volume of vessel divided by volume of a lead shot. So finally you will get 100 answer. Okay, see here, our next problem is, a spear of diameter 6 cm is dropped in a right circular cylindrical vessel partly filled with water. The diameter of cylindrical vessel is 12 cm. If the spear is completely submerged in water, by how much will the level of water rise in the cylindrical vessel? Okay, that is the given question. Now see here, what is given? A spear of diameter 6 cm. Diameter of spear is given, that is 6 cm. So definitely radius will be 3 cm. Radius is equals to 3 cm. Is dropped into a right circular cylindrical vessel. Cylindrical vessel partly filled with water. It is not completely filled, partly filled. Okay, suppose that water level is like this. We will see here. Now what they have told us, the diameter of cylindrical vessel is 12 cm. Diameter of this is cylindrical vessel is 12 cm. If the sphere is completely submerged in water, means it is like that, completely submerged in the cylindrical vessel, if the sphere is completely submerged in water, by how much will the level of water rise in the cylindrical vessel? That is the question. Okay, when it is completely submerged, that time definitely its water level is going to increase. Suppose this is initial level, we will say this is initial, and when it is submerged, that time water level is going to increase. Okay, means after that, okay, when it will be merged in that time its water level is definitely going to increase. Okay, so one thing is very simple here, that is volume of this sphere is equals to volume of this cylinder. Okay, here they are asking what is the rise in the cylindrical vessel, means we have to find out height. Okay, that we will take h, let the height of the cylindrical portion which is raised afterwards, that height will be h. Understood? So here we have to find out volume of this cylindrical vessel, or volume of this cylinder whose height is h, is equals to volume of sphere. Okay, because due to this sphere, this water level is going to increase. Understood? So we will find out here first volume of sphere. Volume of sphere is equals to 4/3 pi r³. Okay, so 4/3 pi we will keep as it is, multiply by radius. Radius is given 3 cm, so 3 × 3 × 3 cm³. So 3 will be cancelled, 4 × 3 = 12, 12 × 3 = 36 pi. 36 pi is the volume of sphere. Now we will find out volume of cylinder whose of height h. Okay, means this. Okay, because this volume and this will be same. So volume of cylinder is equal to, what is the formula? πr² h. Okay, so here what is given? See, radius is given in a right circular vessel. The diameter of cylindrical vessel is 12 centimeter. Diameter is given 12 centimeter. So radius will be, radius is equals to 6 centimeter. Radius of this is 6 centimeter. So we can use capital R also. Okay, so here I am taking capital R. Pi R square H. Okay, height that we are going to find out. So pi into height is radius is 6 square multiplied by H. So 36 pi h. Okay, so definitely this volume of sphere and volume of cylinder whose height is h, that will be same. So now we can equate them. So finally 36 pi h is equals to 36 pi. So definitely this pi will be cancelled, 36 will be cancelled. So h is equals to 1 centimeter. Height is 1 centimeter, means water level will increase by 1 centimeter. Okay. Okay, see here our third problem is a hemispherical bowl of internal radius 15 centimeter contains a liquid. The liquid is to be filled into cylindrical shaped bottles of diameter 5 centimeter and height 6 centimeter. How many bottles are necessary to empty the bowl? Okay, so here see first statement, a semi hemispherical bowl of internal radius 15 centimeter contains liquid. Very simple question. Hemispherical bowl contains liquid. Okay, the liquid is to be filled into cylindrical shaped bottles. This liquid is to be filled into cylindrical bottles. Okay, and here we have to find out how many bottles are required to fill same amount of liquid. Understood? So here first we need to find out volume of this hemispherical bowl, and then we will find out volume of a cylinder, and volume of hemispherical bowl divided by volume of cylindrical bottle. Okay, so you will get number of bottles. So first I am doing here volume of hemispherical bowl is equals to 2/3 pi r cube. Okay, radius is given 15 centimeter. Radius that we will take small r is equal to 15 centimeter. Okay, so now put here values 2/3 into pi into 15 cube into centimeter cube. Okay, so 15 cube is 3375. So 2/3 into 3375 multiply by pi into centimeter cube. Okay, so here we can do 3 ones are 3 twos are 6, 1 3 fives are 15, 1125 multiply by 2, so that will be 2250 pi centimeter cube. 2250 pi centimeter cube is the volume of that hemispherical bowl. Okay, now we will find out volume of a cylindrical bottle. Volume of cylindrical bottle is equals to pi r square h. Now we are going to use capital R because now this radius is different. So here it is given R, capital R is given. Cylindrical shaped bottles of diameter 5 centimeter. Diameter is 5 centimeters, means radius will be 5/2 centimeter. And what is given, height is h is equal to 6 centimeter. Height is also given, so directly we can find out its volume. So h is equals to 6 centimeter. Okay, now put here values, pi we will keep as it is, multiply by radius is 5/2 into 5/2 multiply by 6. Okay, so here we can divide, 2 3s are 6. Okay, so 5 5 5s are 25, 25 3s are 75 pi by 2. This is the volume of a cylindrical bottle. Okay, question is find out how many bottles are necessary to empty the bowl. Means here we are going to find out number of bottles required. Okay, so number of bottles is equals to this volume of hemispherical bowl divided by volume of a cylindrical bottle. Okay, so 2250 pi divided by 75 pi upon 2. So 2250 pi multiplied by 2 upon 75 pi. Okay, so pi we can cancel here. 75, 3s are 225, this 0, 32 is a 60. So 60 bottles are required to empty this hemispherical bowl. Okay, so required answer is 60.